Hello, welcome back, guys. Thank you for joining me. I'm so grateful that you're here. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day wherever you find yourself in this world today. Today, we're going to be calling in the violet flame of transmutation with Saint Germain and Master Almari to come in and arrange our service with God so that it aligns with what He prescribes for our life, allowing us to fully be able to take advantage of every level in our lives so that we know everything that's organized for us, having extreme care in the details of our life, unity-wide, and consciousness, having divine order coming in. Tuning in to a calm center from within, a place from stillness. You'll be able to make strong decisions in this spot and have intuitive wisdom that will courageously emerge simultaneously as you're coming forth as a universal protector in your life, having patience to relax in your own inner knowing and the acquired wisdom to understand the role that you play on this earth and transmute that into God's love for you, the supreme love from the Most High God, the mastery of spiritual forces, if you would. Thank you. Amen. All right, so this is for Earth signs, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. And this is Soul Truth Oracle. What do we got? How am I apologizing for my truth? Okay, so what part of you, your truth, are you apologizing for and why? Today, be proud of your truth and catch yourself when you want to apologize or withhold parts of you. You never know whose life you will change when you are brave enough to speak up. Be the lighthouse that shines on the courage that lives in all of us. This will give others permission to speak their own truth. Today's mantra is, for today, I'll be courageous. Okay. So, and as we're doing that, let's go ahead and make a couple, you know, like a gratitude list. What are the things that you love and what are the things that you have a gratitude and appreciation for in your life? And how can that help change and shape your mindset for things to come? What kind of revelations can you receive from your meditations and visions as you're coming forth? Right? Okay, any angel numbers for today? All right. So we have 999. Chapter in your life is closing, allowing another to open. So, yes, as we're putting gratitude out there for all that is and everything going on in the universe, it's allowing us to close doors and open the other ones that are right for us so that we can come in with the application of divine justice with and helping us through any kind of initiations in our life, being oriented towards, you know, liquidation of karmic debts in your life, closing all those doors, leading to victory and establishing peace in your life. Okay, so crown chakra number 9, the unlimited self. Crown chakra activations, connecting to spirit, connecting to those transpersonal chakras. That could be in meditation, yoga, chanting, mudras, however it is that you get into that, or just literally going in nature and allowing the stillness to come over you in any type of way. And if it takes, you know, you to open up those chakras in a chaotic manner, you know, getting active and going in there and jumping into that so that you can get the freedom down here with the dragonfly, the freedom and the transformation that's coming to you. If you need to connect with your friends, with your animals, spirit animals, whatever it is that you need to connect with to allow you to get in that peaceful solitude, that silence, that serenity. What do we got over here? Okay, we have the initiation, rite of passage, crossing the threshold, and the age of light. You've been training for this for lifetimes. So, how are are you apologizing in your future? Okay, so somebody could be having like past life memories, past life. You know, it's like taking the journey of the divine adventures that are coming to our life, trusting in your divine source, your God self. Your intuition guides you within. How are you listening to that? And is that taking you piece by piece, place by place, step by step as you expand into that knowledge and understanding? You know, a whole understanding, understanding, outer standing, all, you know, of your friends, your partners, your brothers and sisters. You know, we laugh together. We are equally yoked to find the divine within our own hearts. And how are you sharing that unconditional love with each other freely? Is it simply who we are, or is it second nature, you know, devoted no matter the time, space, or reason? It's the ultimate surrender to the divine will for our life, so that we can share as much as we can while we're still here, only taking our souls to the eternal life here. At the age of life, it's like reminding you that even if you're exhausted or emotional, that the breakthrough is coming with the rune here, breakthrough. If you've had any constraint, any kind of thing holding you back, it's pushing you forward so that you can have the movement with the divine force, with the universal manifestations, you know, working with the keys, the sacred key knowledge that we're given, each one of us, for our own blueprint, for our own divine justice to come forward, allowing us to see everything that we need to, while for what it is. And then with all the pink, it's like affection, compassion, right? The feminine energy. So being coming in soft, coming in steel, you know, allowing for everything to expand upon. And see how the light is like going all the way through her chakra systems, up into divine source. It's like the divine is allowing you to see aspects of yourself from other people's point of views, for one, for things in your past, in your past lives, allowing you to see who you was then, so that you can incorporate any kind of spiritual gifts or anything, any knowledge, any wisdom from those past lives into now, and allow that to propel you forward. Because each of those things for you are chosen by the divine. Like, everybody has something in their life that allows them to be chosen, whether it's, you know, using their hands for something, supernatural, you know, gifts, you know, some type of powerful sense of God's call on your life is literally what it is. It's God's call on your life to allow you to connect to your inner child, to connect to your past lives, to connect to your own Akashic records, right? I'm not saying try to connect to somebody else's, connecting to your own, because it's all interdependent here on each other. But we're all looking inside of ourselves to see where we can come forth and bring that energy out to the world. And then we have protection here, room for protection. So it's like your life changes when you realize that you can still be humble and calm, but not tolerating disrespect, you know, setting perfect boundaries in your life for yourself and others. That way you can go forth with that completed project after the initiation, with that rhythm, with that stepping forward and growing, going onward and upward to what exactly God has called you to do in this life. Let's put this down here. Okay, so let's get, again, this is for earth signs, Captain Taurus, Virgo. All right, what's going on here? So with this cassette, it's like outdated thinking, replaying events over in your head. So as well as looking at the events and just acknowledging them, you have to be able to come to a point where you accept your responsibility in the events, and you stop replaying them over and over again, and just allow the allow the lesson to initiate, and that way you can have progression, that way you can move forward to where God is trying to lead you to. And then we just cut the boat. So the boat says, receiving what you need, progression, arriving, moving on, closure. Okay. So again, with closure, where do you, in your life, do you need to have closure, and how can you get that closure for yourself, to protect yourself, to protect this breakthrough, to protect the doors that are opening in your life, that way you don't shut them before they can even be opened, you know, denied them before they even happen. Okay. So, the butterfly, relationship evolving to the next phase, healing inner child growth. Okay, so we just talked about that healing child, healing inner child. And then I keep hearing the clock. I've been hearing this for a couple months. It's like TikTok in my head. But how is that? Is that the initiation of the change, the initiation of the healing, the initiation of the growth, leading towards victory, leading towards establishing peace in your life, leading towards not feeling like you're not enough, not feeling like that spiritual charisma that comes forth to give you that stability with the palm tree, to give you that stability, that joy, that flexibility, that permeance, right? And then we have date. So meeting someone new. You could be meeting somebody new, or getting back in the dating scene, you know, getting back out there to plan or set a date in your life. Or this could not actually mean dating, but it just be, could just be like a date. A date is coming forth in, for you to get out there and allow yourself to be, excuse me, what the heck? Allowing yourself to enjoy yourself, allowing yourself to be with your friends, allowing yourself to be with your family. And if not, if you're with somebody, it's like, when is the last time you guys went on a date and got to really experience each other, you know, one-on-one? When's the last time that you got to do that? And then I literally, the coffee cup come up. So, again, meeting, conversation, savoring the moment, feeling uplifted. So, in friendship and with others. I'm not telling you if you're not dating, get out there, you know, and just start dating, but... right here we have the Phoenix for the last one, and it's a new phase. So renew, transformation, growth, changed mind. How have you changed your mind for some of the things that are going on in your life? How has this shaped your way that you see things? Do you have, are you ready to do anything to get what you want, you know? Are you ready to come forth, you know, and believe in yourself as you're, you know, believe in yourself as you're going through this? How do you believe in yourself? Do you have more misfortune or despair? Do you have more materialistic interests instead of, you know, soul-centered compassions, right? Are you really, you know, do you really believe in God, or is it some kind of evil demonic mission, you know, with the diabolical forces? And how is that guiding you with your passions? Or are you seeing these things go on in your life and acting with the universe to make a change for those things, make a change for others, make a change for your self, right? Going towards your passions, you know, full force as you want to do so. Okay, so is what you see and what you think about manifests into your life, right? So what are you manifesting into your life? What are you manifesting into your life right now that allows you to work with the divine, work with God, you know, work with the concept of the universal creator, right? So, and what do we got here? We got the Four of Swords. So, healing. Lots of healing going on. Well, we're all always healing, right, in some way, shape, or form. If it's just having a laugh with our friends to get us out of, you know, to get us a different change of scenery. If it's actually healing work happening with the Ace of Staffs there, somebody could actually be doing healing work as a job or going forth passionately. Healing their, with the date here, with their love life, with their friends' relationships, with the new chapters. Even somebody could be moving homes here. Their family could be moving homes. Something about a baby as well. So somebody could be moving homes because they added a new addition to their life. And that's allowing them to start up, you know, that whole new closing open doors, so that the baby has brought somebody together. Now, I'm not saying to have a baby to bring somebody together. It just looks like having that baby has brought somebody together. Even if maybe they didn't feel like they were going to be together, they're just together for the baby. It's like you see that as an act of destiny, as an act for you to heal from something. Or maybe this is one of these things is what has caused somebody to feel like they need to heal from these situations and come forth, right? And then we have the High Priestess and the Nine of Cups. So definitely somebody intuitively knows that somebody's coming in for an offer to offer, relationship to offer, some type of emotional stability. Just make sure you know when you have discernment when going into offers, you know? It's like, look at her face. She just kind of looks, I don't want to say smug, but that's almost what it looks like. She's just kind of out there, not really looking for a date. And here he is coming in. Again, with that not blocking what's coming towards you, or if you're in a relationship already, how are you blocking that relationship towards actually reaching your heart space? And allowing what you do and what you know to allow you to go within to see if this is the right person for you. Is this the right place for you? Is this the right thing for you to be doing with the Two of Cups here? It looks like the Divine is saying it is. With all these butterflies and dragonflies, it's like transformation of your love life, transformation of your home life. Some type of initiation, rite of passage is going through, and it's allowing you to open yourself up to universal frequencies, universal knowledge, universal love. With the Two of Cups, it's like you're feeling, you filled your own cup up with love, so it helps you to be able to, you know, go into a relationship. Go into a relationship, you know, with love as the only thing on your mind. That way you're not blocked by things that have happened to you in your past, or any kind of distortions or illusionary, or, you know, and you're seeing through, you're trusting in the love of your heart, you're trusting in the love of divine, you know, you're trusting in your instincts, you're trusting in your higher self with the highest priestess there, so that you can, even things that you don't know, it's like you'll be led there correctly, accurately, trusting in, you know, the flow of life. How are you being guided? How is your sacred temple opening up to these things? And are you allowing yourself to be guided in all things by your wise instinctive knowing? You know, it's like you're not afraid to be seen in here. It's not, you're not afraid to be seen. You're not just hiding in the house. Hiding in the house like some people do, or sometimes, and if you do feel called to hide in your house, it's like your intuition is giving you that knowledge, it's giving you that forefront. With the King of Swords here, this could be an Aries, Libra, Gemini, or they just have that energy. Cut forth, you know, decisive effort, going within, knowing when to release and when to hold things, so that you can have your emotional fulfillment, so that you can have that slow and steady rinse and waste kind of love there with this energy that's coming in to bring you this. Because that's not only is it air energy, it's water energy. Or this could just be the energy that you're in right now. You know, you could embody all these energies together. It's like not only are you, you know, wise and truthful and instinctive, you're emotional and intuitive, and you allow the divine to guide you. You allow everything to be unveiled at the right time, right? You have that perfect beauty within you. And then the ending of a phase of juggling. Then we have the Empress here. So the Empress could be you. The Empress could be this other person. There could be two women and one man here. And this could be some kind of third party situation, but it's like God is allowing everything to be illuminated. Or this could be one energy and that could be another for the man and the woman. Either way, it's like, again, I keep getting this energy of like a man who is really actually a man in this high priest. Well, I guess that would be the high priest, but a really intuitive man in your life. it wants to come forth. And I mean, like, not just like intuitive, I know where I'm going, I'm being led. Like, this actually, like, almost psychic person coming into your life or is in your life that has, and see how the cards that has initiated this rite of passage or this next level of growth, if you would. You know, like, because when you're with your divine counterpart, when you guys have sexual experiences or the closer you are together, it's like a new initiation, it's a new way of coming forth. And each time, I'm not saying each and every time, but it's like a new thing develops, a new thing envelops with you. That doesn't mean you have to be with them to do this, but it's like each time you're closer to them, something new, something comes forth, you know, some type of, you know, with the outdated thinking, some type of new mindset, some type of new way of being comes forward. You know, it's almost like a spiritual death and rebirth, just in the experience in itself. And that doesn't have to be, you know, a sexual experience, but a lot of times, a lot of people do, you know, compare that to the, you know, the Kundalini rise and all that. But if that's not it, it's just literally the closeness in the 5D being brought down to the 3D and allowing yourself to be led by all those things and going within, you know. And what are you manifesting at this time? Well, we got the Magician and the Nine of Pentacles. You're manifesting what you wish to have in your life. You're manifesting that new way of being. You're manifesting, and at the bottom of this we have Virgo. So you could be a Virgo, or this could be about a Virgo. Manifesting independence, manifesting awareness, manifesting abundance for yourself, for your family. If you don't have a family, it's like for yourself. Making plans and seeing how you're going to go forth in the future. Okay, so we got Twin Ray. So this could be your Twin Ray. Okay. So, Divine Orchestration just came out. So the Divine is orchestrating this. If you've invoked any of your free will, you know, to give permission to the universe to come in and orchestrate things happening in your life, right? So that you can step on the path that you're supposed to be, so that you can heal yourself. And heal your life, heal your mother and father lines, you know, going forth. We got past life memories. So I kind of touched on that a little bit earlier. So somebody, again, is having past life memories. I feel like the cards are just kind of confirming everything I'm saying here. You know, thoughts. And then we got Samadhi. Okay, so again, Stop the wheel of thoughts turning in your head. Get rid of that duality, right? Thoughts that don't lead to another thought, that leads to a lasting, you know, you have a lasting feeling of a connection to all, right? To all that is, to all that wherever will be, right? It's that extrasensory sensory intake, you know. How are you detaching to these outcomes as well that you're manifesting here with the Magician and allowing things to flow into your life? You're detaching from the miseries of life, you know. You're allowing yourself to perceive things in a different way. Okay, that was a message. Lots of growth happening. Human Truth Oracle, the last message of spirit. Thank you. Want to be more than friends. I hid who I really am. Here, it was my fault. I blamed you. Regret lying to you, and I left when I saw you with somebody else. On the bottom of the deck, my life is not as together as it seems. Yeah, those are honest statements. So, however you're coming forth and giving these statements out, it's like you're being honest with yourself. You're being honest with others, which is a beautiful thing, right? Okay, so this is all I got for today, guys. I hope you have a great weekend, and I love you guys.